Hi everyone, this is Dr. Santosh. Today I'll talk about constitutive heterochromatin and facultative heterochromatin. So in this lecture, I'll be also talking about the functions and differences, their differences, okay? Let's begin. So what does constitutive heterochromatin means? So constitutive heterochromatin is the heterochromatin that is always there, okay? The heterochromatin is always there, whatever is the stage of development. Okay, it is always there. So so constitutive means it is always there. So this, where do we find this constitutive heterochromatin? We find this constitutive heterochromatin at two places. First, at centromere, and second, at telomere. Okay, now these sequences, these both places, this DNA in this region, they are tandemly repeated. Okay, tandem, what means? The same type of repeat, same type of DNA sequence will repeat many times. Here also same type of DNA sequence will repeat many times. Okay, what is the function of this telomere? The telomere will protect the end of DNA. You know, the each replication cycle, the DNA is shortened a little bit. But this telomere will protect. There is enzyme called telomerase. Okay, this is a very important enzyme. Okay, frequently tested in exams about telomerase. This is nothing but this is RNA dependent DNA polymerase. It is a protein. You say this is a protein, and protein will have a short RNA sequence that actually will polymerize TTAG. Sequence TTAGG sequence. It will polymerize multiple times, so there will be multiple sequence of TTAGG here on the end of the each DNA chromatin. So this is how this telomere will protect this end. Okay, So when this telomere is shortened, so DNA will not be that effective. So this is related to aging. So this is very important, heterochromatin. One of the constitutive heterochromatin is present in the chromosome at telomere. Other constitutive heterochromatin is present at the centromere. Now the centromere also have tandemly repeated sequence, and you know the centromere provides an attachment site for tubulin during cell division at anaphase stage. Okay, and also this centromere will provide the attachment of these two chromatid. So this is the function of these two heterochromatin, centromere and telomeric heterochromatin. One will protect DNA, other will provide attachment site for tubulin and attachment of this six sister chromatid. So these are the function of constitutive heterochromatin. And one very important thing about this, they are gene deficient region. They don't have gene. Okay, their function is different than protein synthesis or RNA synthesis. DNA, they are generally structural. Now, second type of heterochromatin is facultative heterochromatin. This facultative heterochromatin is also called opportunistic heterochromatin. So this type of heterochromatin you will not see always. It is not always present. This heterochromatin only present when it is needed. So one very important difference between constitutive heterochromatin DNA region and facultative. Facultative DNA, heterochromatin DNA will have G. Okay, so this is the very important difference. One, this has G. Now you can, what you can see is this. What is the, now you take, you will wonder what is the function of this facultative heterochromatin. Then you will understand. Let's talk about one function. When see one thing like zygote. Let's see zygote. Zygote will be, you know, zygote will have almost all set of gene active in zygote. But and because it is a totipotent cell, you can see totipotent cell. So you know that zygote will produce. Zygote will differentiate ultimately into what? Muscle. Zygote will differentiate ultimately into neurons. Zygote will differentiate ultimately into liver cells. Everything is zygote, even kidney, other things. Everything is derived from zygote. How does it happen? So actually, this zygote has the all set of gene active. But what will happen is, let's say a set of genes, let's say there's five genes, this one, two, third, and fourth, and five. Now, muscle, let's say muscle will have combination of one, two, three gene active. Okay, so one set one will be active here. Now, four, five gene will be inactive. This will be switched off for muscle. Now, when you take neurons, let's say neurons will have different set of gene is active. Three, four, five, that will characterize different combination will characterize a different as neuron. So it will have this, and then one and two will be inactive. Different sets of active and inactive genes will be there for neurons, and different sets of active and inactive genes will be for muscles, and so on for other tissue also. Now, when you see this, these two genes are, let's say, switched off for neuron cell. How are they switched off? They are switched off because of heterochromatin formation, and this heterochromatin formation is called facultative heterochromatin formation. Basically, the switching off will happen at the nucleosome region. And this is histone, and histone has tail, this is histone octamer. This host histone octamer will have histone tail, and that tail, if methylation happens very heavily, it is the lysine component of that histone, if it is very heavily methylated, what will happen is this whole thing, DNA will clump together and that gene will be switched off. So this is one of the function of this facultative heterochromatin. Is the facultative heterochromatin plays role in differentiation of the cells. And other role of this facultative heterochromatin is to take part in epigenetic regulation. So the twin brothers, okay, when they live in different environment, let's say this brother goes to the mountain, they lives in mountain, and this brother will live in the plain region. What will happen is the environment for both of them, they are different. Okay, though genetically they are very similar, the environment will be completely different. The food this guy will eat will be completely different than this. So, and then if you change the environment, what will happen is there will be certain gene that will be active in this individual that would be required for survival in the mountain region. But the same other set of gene will be active here that will be required to live for this individual in the plain region. And for that matter, other set of the set one is active here and set two will be inactive here. Set two, let's say set two will be active and set one will be inactive. So those kind of modification can happen because of environmental effect. And not only that, so this environmental effect you can experience in yourself also when you keep eating for a longer period of time. So there will be a certain set of gene that will be active, and that will cause fatty acid synthesis, constant fatty acid synthesis, and there your fatty acid oxidation will be shut down. So this is also because of epigenetic modification. Some gene will be switched off. So this heterochromatin formation will lead to epigenetic modification. This is second function. Now third very important significant function, you will see the bar body formation. You will see bar body formation also is because of this heterochromatin formation. How does what is the role of bar body formation? It is called gene doses compensation. Now let's see the whole thing here on the table. Now you can see here, as I told you, the role of constitutive heterochromatin is protection and attachment side of sister chromatid and for tubulin also. Now here, what is the role of this facultative heterochromatin? Epigenetic regulation, differentiation, gene doses compensation, and that is for bar body formation. And then differentiation, different tissue happens because of this facultative heterochromatin formation. So I told you this, remember this facultative heterochromatin means gene containing region, and constitutive heterochromatin is no gene. So but when you see this two concept, I have tried to separate the two concepts completely separately, but there is some gray region. So gray region is this. Okay, so I'll talk this little separately. Let me first explain all this. Now you can see this is no gene region, and I told you this is satellite region, and the cyclic DNA is present in centrosome, and this what is satellite tandemly repeated sequences there, and this is gene deficient, and very always it is always condensed because there's many tandemly repeated regions. So there is polymorphism, so one individual may have, let's say, 1000 tandem repeats and other individual may have 1100 tandem repeats. So this is called polymorphism. In same individual, one chromosome, one maternal chromosome may have like 1000, other maternal chromosome may have 100. So this is called polymorphism, that you can see in constitutive heterochromatin, because it is the DNA which is tandemly repeated, non-gene containing tandemly repeated sequences. So that is what polymorphism is present. Here polymorphism is not present. Now when you see things through this electron microscope, through light microscopy, when you stain the chromosome, now when you do C-banding, then you will see constitutive heterochromatin only. You can see constitutive heterochromatin only. You will be able to find out constitutive heterochromatin only. Through C-banding, only constitutive heterochromatin is stained deeply. Other heterochromatin is stained lightly, because during C-banding, we put the whole DNA into acid medium. So that will denature all the chromatin except constitutive heterochromatin. But this facultative heterochromatin, for facultative heterochromatin, C-banding, you will see the lightly stained region for facultative heterochromatin. Okay, now let's talk about this lynase. So lynase, I told you, the facultative heterochromatin gene containing region, which will be switched off in certain cells or because of certain environmental effect, and it will be switched off, whole gene will be switched off for Barbary. This facultative heterochromatin is gene-containing region, but this is also we call facultative heterochromatin. This lynase sequence you will see as a dark band in chromosome. This dark banded lynase region. What is lynase? Lynase is a transposons. There's rudimentary transposons. About 45 to 50% of genome our genome is made up of this transposons. One of them, those transposons, is sinus sequences. That's sinus and lynase sequences. So this is lynase, okay, long interspersed nucleotide sequence. Okay, it is long interspersed nucleotide sequences. This is transposons. So you can see this transposons here, and this heterochromatin region that you see in chromosome in G banding is basically mainly composed of this lynase. On you will find this heterochromatin formation only during metaphase. So that is why this is cytologically, this is, we call it heterochromatin, and it does not have gene. So this is the gray area, that is what I said. It is facultative heterochromatin, but it is gene poor area. You will be, whatever you see in dark band here, in when you stain the chromosome with the G banding, you see they are predominantly lynase sequences. So thank you for today's class.